What is going on, everyone? Leon checking in, and today we're at it again with another video. Today's video is about the Nest Hub Max. Now, it's okay, I already went ahead and I called this the Google Home Hub Max. Now, if you're anything like me, you may have the older device here. This is what you would call the Google Home Hub when it first came out, but now it's called the Nest Hub. So as you can tell, there is a slight identity crisis here. So as we continue on with the channel here, we learn a lot about technology. Now, one of the things that we learn about technology is that as time passes, it seems to get a little bit more complicated. You're packing all this stuff into a smaller package. So in theory, the technology is very simple, but there's a lot going on. So what that means is when it comes to videos, we want a lot more information. We have questions like what the technology looks and feels like, what features does the technology have, what is it like to set up the technology, and what is it like to use the technology. So basically, including all these topics in one video would make a very long video, a complicated video, and a video that possibly would not be detailed enough on each individual subject. So with that being said, I'm looking to make a video series about each individual device so that I can make a video that's detailed on each one of those subjects. So today we're going to keep things a little bit more simple and start with the unboxing of the Nest Hub Max. So with that being said, let's go ahead and get into it. So here we are with the packaging, and we're going to pull the lid off here. Now here we have the Nest Hub Max, and we're going to try to pull this out. We've got some instructions, and then in here we have our power supply. Now as you can see, I opted for the chalk colored unit here. This gives my Google Nest Hub Max its white and gray two-tone scheme. Okay, so here we are with the Nest Hub Max, and you can see we have a 10-inch HD screen. If you want to know just how much bigger this is compared to the Nest Hub, we can just simply grab the Nest Hub and we could set it right there. Okay, so we wouldn't be doing this justice if we didn't show a side shot of the profile of the Nest Hub Max. And just for size reference, we actually have the Nest Hub here as well. The Nest Hub Max has a very slim profile, which is very, very nice. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna have going on here is the camera, and that's going to be different than the Nest Hub because the Nest Hub obviously doesn't have one. Now, Google calls this the Nest Camera, and with this camera, you'll be able to make video calls and leave video messages. With the camera, you can also check in on your home and you can get motion alerts sent directly to your smartphone. The cool thing about this camera too is that it can also recognize your face and it can personalize your content according to your face. And with a Nest Aware subscription, you should also be able to access continuous video recording and familiar facial alerts. Now, the other cool thing about the Nest Hub Max that I won't be able to really show right now is there is an indicator light somewhere about right there. And then we have this circle right here. I'm not exactly sure what that is, but this does have a sensor for gesture controls, and I believe that's what that's for, but we will learn more once I actually get this up and running in the next video. Now, if we take a closer look here, we're also gonna have two mics, and that's just going to be so the device can hear you. Now, just like the camera where you can get motion alerts, you can get sound alerts from these mics that will also be sent to your smartphone. Okay, so here we are at the base, and we have this material on here, and it doesn't really have any cushion, but this part is what gives the device its color scheme. If we take a look at the underside here, that's going to be completely white, so that might possibly get stained easily. Now on this device, you can't actually see the speakers, but there should be one about here and then another about right there. So looking at the back of the device here, you can see more of that chalk color there. And we also have some useful controls. On the left side of the device here, you can see we actually have a volume rocker. If you press the upper portion, that will increase the volume, and if you press the lower portion, that will decrease the volume. The other thing that we have going on here is if you are someone who's possibly paranoid about cameras and mics being on all the time, we do have this little slider here, and that will turn off the camera and the mic if you just slide that to the right. Now on the back of the device, we're going to have what Google calls a woofer, and that's going to be located here. You can actually see through the fabric, and see where the outline of this would be.
Now, as you can see, we have our port for our power supply, and that's going to be a proprietary connection. And of course, that means it's not USB-C. So it's not like what you would have on your newest Chromebook or Android smartphone.
Now, if we look at the actual power supply here, this is pretty important because we always get these power supplies that are either big or they're weird shape, but this one has a nice rectangular shape, and the important thing is that it doesn't cover the other outlet.
Now, there are a lot of things that can be done with this device. I don't really know much about it yet because I actually haven't set it up, which is why we're going to be making more videos. But there will also be things like gesture control, so we can control things by just using our hands. And then I'm sure there are a lot of other things, which is why I'm going to be making other videos. But what I can initially say about the Nest Hub Max is it's just a clean, minimalist looking design. It's going to have quite a few features compared to the Nest Hub, which I'm very excited to try out. In the next video, we will be looking into how to set up the Nest Hub Max and then just try out the basic features. So if you enjoyed this video and found it useful, make sure to leave a like. If you have any questions or comments, as always, drop those down below, and I can try to include those in the next series of videos for the Nest Hub Max. Now, if you want to support the channel, you can do so by sharing this video with someone who might find it useful. You can also support the channel by clicking the subscribe button. So that is pretty much it, and until next time, Leon checking out.